But it was a call to the morning. It was a call to life. It was called, as far as Winston Churchill was concerned, his belief in eternal life. All the grandeur of the world, all the prestige that he had, it came down to a man of faith to say that I believe in the resurrection. Father Gray did the same in the planning of this service. It wasn't in detail. He wouldn't have liked all of the English aristocracy to render, especially the royal family. He was part German and Irish. But the reality was is that he wanted to leave a message. And the message he wanted to leave was an understanding of eternal life. That all that we do, beginning to end, is eternal life. And that even when we face our own mortality, he wanted to share with us that gift. One of the gifts that he shared with you in this marriage is the gift of priesthood. He considered priesthood a blessing of God. He saw that in that blessing, he developed fully as a man of God, as a priest of Jesus Christ. He was tough on himself and tough on others. He could understand why others, especially the priesthood, did not fully appreciate the greatness of being a priest as he did. In his toughness, he took upon the suffering of others quite easily. It was mentioned that he was down in Mexico for 3 years. Thanks to the goodness of the Cardinal, let him out of the diocese for 3 years to help in a poor Mexican parish. I'm sure the Cardinal would have said, well, hey, do the work here. But he recognized that Greg had a mission there. St. Gordia, Misericordia was the name of the parish. And the first day he got there, they brought him into the little parish house. And it was a heat wave in the heat county. And you know how many heat county could be. It was 107. And he told me that the first night he was in the heat county, the only thing he could do was put a sheet on the floor with a pillow and lay on the cement floor. That was the only cool spot in the entire place. There was no air conditioning, no fan. And he told me that. He said, when he laid on the floor for the first night in the county, what did I get myself into? I think he wanted to call you before I come back. The next day, the people in the county said, Father, we come in, you know? No, that's not legal. He would not give in. He felt it was his duty, his way of doing things. The suffering that comes in is to be offered in a special way. He took that to heart. He felt his call was to the poorest of the poor, those who are needy. And so he took upon himself with the sense of the first reading and the second reading of justice, that our lives are not complete unless we're doing justice to our neighbors. We can be contented with air conditioning and fans, but when my brother is not, that I must be with my brother or sister. He believed the parish belonged to the people in God's name. And they made the choice and direction of their life in that parish. Yes, the priests and the diocese and all the hierarchies, they give direction to people bring life to that parish. And that's why you in this parish so loved him so much. It was always complete for the people. He used every avenue he could to be for the people. He invited me down one time to visit his parish. Because he's going to Misericordia. Thanks be to God, it was only 95. And what we did that evening is that in the little parish church in front of it, it's a dirt road. And the way they dampen down the dirt road is they have a water truck come by and they put water on the road. And that dampens the dust. Every day, the water truck comes to dampen the road. After they dampen it, we came and made the road